Hello, everybody.
I'm the romantic avocado.
And I wanted to paint a character from one of the Sonic movies, but I've already painted a lot of Jim Carrey's Robotniks, so I just decided I should paint Sonic to fight him. I have no idea why I am doing this, nor why I'm making a video on it.
Blah, 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 blah.
Nobody cares! Nobody cares!
So the first thing I'll need if I want to paint a Sonic is a Sonic head.
And because I do not have the official piece and would not want to paint on one even if I did have it, I just downloaded a 3D file. Once they were done printing, I then gently removed the supports with no problem at all. I was very calm and everything went fine. I then saw which of the three heads fit because I printed three at slightly different sizes. Sonic's little nose was so skinny I was afraid of it just breaking off super easily, so I put a few drops of super glue around it just to strengthen it a bit. And then I used my extra super photography skills to get a vivid shot of me spray painting them white, because I'm super good at recording stuff. And now that it is primed, I primed it again because I'm stupid with another white paint marker. I don't know why I decided to coat it twice and do different things of white, but anyways, I just did. I then decided on this very dull, boring blue because I figured it matches Sonic's personality the most. I then sloppily applied the paint onto the torso and the legs in just a very thin layer. That way, it just has a little bit of color and will kind of have a texture of fur. Or at least that's what I was hoping. Now, because this head is 3D printed, sometimes the filament just goes a little crazy and has a few little bumps, and I did not notice that he had some on his chin, so I then had to clip those off, and then once they were clipped off, I put super glue around the little divot, because I don't know why there was a divot. Just to sort of bulk it out and make it look smoother. I also used the same white paint marker for the eyes. That way his eyes are shinier than just normal paint texture, because it will look better. And then I started painting the gloves and then realized how hard it was to record myself while painting. So I pretty much stopped recording. I also used the shiny green paint for Sonic's eyes.
attempted to paint the expression of this Sonic from the Sonic Movie 2 poster, so here are some photos of the progress. I then also used this red Sharpie for his shoes. I didn't take any pictures of me painting them. And this blue for his quills. You can't really see it in the video, but you can in person. And after that, I'm done. So here's the figure.